If all you want to do is play along with the records or jam with your pals, that's fine. Nothing wrong with it at all. But if you want to get involved with the more technical side of drumming, you must learn the rudiments, or at least some of them. Here are two or three exercises I think you should know and practice. Firstly, the single stroke roll. Try to keep all the notes evenly spaced and of the same volume. Practice holding a constant speed and practice changing the speed. Something like this. And playing your singles for as long as you can, or whatever speed is comfortable, is a great way of building up the strength in your wrists and your fingers. Next we move to doubles, or daddy mommies. Two notes each hand, dad da mama. With this simple exercise, we get to practice finger control, and it gives us the ability to move around the kit playing very fast runs. And of course, it's the basis of the drum roll. So now, paradiddles. Paradiddles are really great because both hands do the same thing at different points of the pattern. This allows for a change of hand notation in any pattern you may be playing, which sometimes can be very important when you have to get back around the kit. As most of you know, the notation for a paradiddle is right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. It goes like this. There's an added bonus in paradiddles. There are nice rhythmic patterns inside the rudiment. Single, double, and triple paradiddles all lend themselves very easily to a 4-4 feel. Here's the pattern of a single paradiddle. Many a disco record has used that pattern. Here's a pattern of a double paradiddle. I've used these two rudiments in many songs with Deep Purple to form the basis of the drum parts. Chasing Shadows was a complete double paradiddle played between two different tom-toms. It has a 4-4 feel, so it's easy to put in there. You Fool No One is based almost entirely around a single paradiddle. It tends to cheat a little bit at the end where it becomes a sort of paradiddle-diddle on the cowbell. Hopefully, these examples of the little secrets in rudiments will give you some ideas of your own. Remember, many of these exercises were invented a long time ago for generals to communicate orders to their armies, and our use of them in music over the last 100 years has changed. So be inventive. Look inside them. Find all the wonderful little rhythmic patterns there are there. Oh, and remember, whether you prefer an orthodox grip or a matched grip, remember, the sticks must balance comfortably in your hand. Don't hold them too tight. Remember, if you're using your muscles just to hold onto the sticks, you can't use them properly for playing.